Am I even productive? Am I even keep productive? Let's plan a productive week in Notion to figure out that. This was an awkward intro. In order to get myself productive each week, what I actually have is a planning page on my evergreen Notion workspace. So first and foremost, when planning out a week, you can see that there are actually themes in the types of weeks that I have. If we go here, we'll see that I have a monthly task framework, and each week I have a goal of what I'm doing. The first week, my goal is to write, second, record, three, edit and schedule, and four, work on sales funnels, and then this cycle repeats. So what I like to call the grouping of each of those weeks is the weekly highlight. And in order to get to that weekly highlight, I actually have daily highlights here. So for me, each day of the week, I'm gonna plan on doing something to get more close to my weekly highlight being completed. So for me, I work about 6 days out of the week. I try to give myself 1 day a week off, and that's usually Saturday. So today I'm recording videos, and then Tuesday I'm recording videos again. And then Wednesday I'm editing videos, and then I'm editing more videos. And then once again, I'm finishing off with editing more videos. And Sunday I start getting a lot of the finishing touches done. So what you'll see here is basically I have figured out that this is how I'm going to structure my week, and my goal is to get all the finishing touches done for my videos for the month done on Sunday. So then from there, what you can do to make something like this happen is make what I like to call a task framework. So in Notion, all you need to do is set up a board view that has each day of the week, and then if you make a property for what kind of week it is, if you want to do a monthly schedule like me, or you can do it each day of the week and have it be a recurring every week situation. What I like to do is have it be every week is a different work week so that it's a little bit more broken down and easy to do. So this week, as you'll see, I actually have these tasks of YouTube recording, editing, finish edits. And then once we get onto this week three, you'll see this is the last finish edits day. So I'm essentially using a weekly task framework with recurring tasks by then taking that weekly task framework and then utilizing the button template functionality in Notion. So essentially each of these days has it so that if I press this, the different recurring tasks that I want to do will easily be created. And then I actually have already done this for the week. So I've dragged those onto here. So I've already drag the recording, the editing for the audio, recording again, editing. And I've done this all for Monday through Friday. And then what I'll do on Thursday is I'll actually double check what I have going on for the week and then go further in this weekly task framework to the next week and move those from there as well. And then the question remains, how do I prioritize these tasks once I have them planned? Because obviously things come up. And as you'll see here, I have a bunch of different tasks going on that are outside of what my normal stuff is. So when I go to the actions page in Notion, which is a part of my evergreen Notion workspace, I actually have things sorted in a specific manner. So I have it sorted with my TTP method, which is time, trees, and priorities. So first and foremost, you have time, which is what time it is. So in Notion, by default, you're going to have it so that things that aren't assigned a specific time are at the top. And then under that, things that are assigned a specific time are below those. So for me, I know that I'm recording this at 4:30 in the morning for a start session, and then it's going to be finished when I get to 7 when I start editing some audio. So however many videos I get done by 7, then I can edit from there. And then after that, if I had multiple things that came up on the same day, say I got rid of all of these different things, what would happen is I actually have a task prioritization system based on the different parts of my YouTube work. So content to me is more important than sales funnels, as it is what drives the business. And that is more important than administrative. So if I get rid of all of these different things, and I got rid of all these times associated with when I needed to get things done, since these are all a part of the same tree and I don't have any daily tasks outside of YouTube, this YouTube recording is actually still at the top, because to me, YouTube in this root section has a higher priority than something like the weekly pour over, which would be the podcast. And the same with this video, which is more important than the weekly pour over because it's part of YouTube. But due to the real world that I'm actually living in, I do need to get this done prior. So I'd actually have to include a time and set it to like 8 a.m. to get it done, for example, and then go back and add the different times that I actually need to get things done, because there are deadlines that I have regarding getting that done before the content calendar gets mad at me. And this video actually doesn't really need to be recorded until tomorrow, so I can delegate it to tomorrow. And then from here, these tasks are just things that'll happen throughout the day. Like this guy, I'm obviously going to do later at night. I could put it for 8 p.m., but I need to put my watch on before I go to bed because that's my current 30-day challenge. And then this guy I'll do when there's a lull in the day. And then this I'll do when there's a lull in the day as well. And the nice part about the TTP Hub or Evergreen Notion Workspace is I've actually made a Notion weekly view. If you want to see how to look at your Notion with date properties in a weekly view, you can actually check that video out right here.